mean, look at Brocky. He's a big lightweight.
He'll be. Man, he's not going to be light. He'll be better than that 47.
Yeah, he can't.
Even then, he's a big 47.
He's a big 47. But I'll tell you one thing. It comes that he showed heart. I mean, most guys, most corners were thrown to talent. I'm surprised in California, which I'm not the biggest fan of everything. I mean, Jack Reitz is my man. I think he's a great ref. Jack might have let it go on, but I thought they were going to stop it.
Yeah.
And I was going, oh, man. But I felt so bad for the kid. You got Eddie Hearn there, his first American fight. But this guy was tough.
Listen, do you ever see Jermaine Taylor and Kelly Pavlik?
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Any other ref would have stopped that in the second round. And Kelly Pavlik came back to stop him. So
Kelly Pavlik was supposed to have a chance.
There's a lot of fights. And that's happened.
You're right. It always happens in the movies like that.
Except Rocky. They never stopped.
Last time I had the movies?
In the movies?
Rocky was a disappointment? I thought it was.
My brother got hit in Rocky 1 more than like 50 fighters in their whole career. And they didn't stop. No, Rocky, they never stopped fighting.
Why? They just, there was real
punches?
Well,
then Rocky 3, all of a sudden he was like good looking and intelligent. I said, what happened? I think he got knocked to sense of the brain. Because all of a sudden you see Rocky, yeah, he's doing, you know. And all of a sudden Rocky 3 is like, hello, you're perfect, driving a Ferrari. Like no scars.
But Frank, can I tell you something crazy? When I ask fighters from all over the world, stars, why they got into boxing, I get three answers.
Rocky.
Tyson, Ali, and Rocky.
Yeah.
Is that why?
It was a big, you know, it was a big movie. You know, people, the younger generation didn't get to see anything like that. And the thing is, it's a love story. It's not all about boxing. We're Raging Bull. No one wanted to become a fighter watching Raging Bull.
But yeah, Rocky's just depressing.
Yeah, it's depressing. Yeah,
boxing can be depressing.
Rocky's like an affable person, you know.
He's approachable. Like,
yeah.
Is it true that your brother tried to sell the script at first and no one would buy
Nobody
it?
Nobody wanted it.
They wanted pennies for it?
Yeah, they wanted the script. They didn't want him. They were thinking Ryan O'Neill or Burt Reynolds, which would have been a totally different
thing. Jesus.
But what made it is that Sly was basically unknown, and most of the people in the cast, other than Burgess, are unknown.
You were in it, too. You were singing.
I was in it. I was unknown. I still am. No, I'm not kidding. But, no, I'm really excited for some good fights coming up, man.
What's the story with the dog? Did he have to sell the dog or something?
Did. Probably like did for he? 3 days. They took it
and
back.
They got back?
Butkus.
Oh.
Bull master. Yeah, no, he was broke, man. I mean, you know, I said that's the best business decision you ever made in your life. Because most guys, if they're broke in 1975 and they offer you $300,000,
oh like gosh, huge.
$2 million.
You would jump on it?
Of course. Most people would.
I would.
If you're broke, yeah.
Why wouldn't? Why
but
would
I
you
think
do
the
it?
The thing was, he just felt he had nothing.
My biggest payday before Max Lewis was $10,000. He's a whole bunch of money. I'll do it.
I think the whole thing with all these fighters, man, you just have to position them right. Ray Leonard, all these great fighters were really positioned right.
That's the key.
Right fighters.
To be patient.
Too many hard fights early, you're shot.
Justin, sometimes people get impatient. Not the fighters, management, promoters. They want to rush. Be patient.
What's the best?
You remember management? You first couple of years, it's a losing job.
Yeah, you're right.
You lose a lot of money. It's like racehorses. Same shit. Same shit.
It's like these fighters. Some guys like to fight. They like it.
Yeah.
Like being in the whole thing. And some guys, you know, once they get a taste of any kind of success or money, they get soft. What'd they say? And Rocky, what happened to the guy? He got not like educated. You know, like a fighter's supposed to stay hungry?
Yeah.
He got civilized. But you look at Duran, that was a natural born fighter.
Yeah. He's from the streets. He told me at 5 years old he was working already. Working.
Knocking guys out at 10 years old. I mean, he is a born fighter. That's his.
Yep.
I think Leonard's a born fighter, but Leonard is a little more of a business guy, smart. Tommy Hearns is a born real fighter.
I'm going to tell you what's interesting about Leonard. He only had like 44 fights, 46 fights, where everybody else in his era had 70, 80,
but he
90.
He was fragile.
Yeah, but that's fragile. 47. A lot of those fights were fucking legendary fights. Wars. Yeah, history is some of the best fights out there.
Yeah, great day. And you know, the thing is, he wasn't like a sturdy guy. He had hand problems, he had eye problems. So. Yeah. You know, I mean, you got to give him credit. Who's he fight after a 4-year layoff with the Detachment Bar Pack, who nobody wanted to fight if they fought 4 months ago?
And he beat him?
I think he beat him. You got to watch the fight. People go, no, Hager, why? I said, yeah.
What you told the way is like the difference between them and now is that once they sensed you were hurt, it was over. Him, Ray, Marvin, Tommy, anyone. Once they smell blood, you're fine. And that was it. Now,
I respect Floyd Mayweather, but he could not hung with those guys. Durant, Hearns.
Why not?
He's 50. Too strong.
There's a different men. He's 50 what?
50 and 0.
So what? You have three of those 50, right? Three of those guys are fucking Muppets. And then, you know, it's a different era. They're different men.
Think like about a lot Tommy of guys. Hearns across the ring, 6'1".
A lot of guys can't hang with those guys.
So who in this era would do great in any era? Pacquiao?
Yeah.
I put Leonard.
Canelo?
Hearns. Canelo. Duran. Benitez could have fought in any era. Just skill level.
He's not like 40 years. He's an old school throwback. There's a few of them out there. Not a lot.
Triple G, tough guy, but yeah, he got handled by Hagler. Right? Good puncher, but so was Hagler.
He's fighting in Japan December 29, I think.
Triple G?
Murata, the tall kid.
Really?
Yeah.
What was a good fight?
It's a good fight. In Japan, yeah. New Year's Eve, big fights. Yeah. They...
What's the other Mexican guy that's a super middleweight champion? He wears the cowboy hat, good looking.
Suerto Ramirez. He's now light heavyweight. 42-0, 28 knockouts. He just fought.
He's a handsome guy.
He just got signed by Golden Boy, so.
Because I look at that guy.
There you go. That was handsome.
That was it. No, but a handsome guy, like, he could speak English very well. And he could fight.
42-0, 28 knockouts. He's good. He wants to fight Bivol. He wants.
And Benavides and Plant are probably going. Yeah. That guy was a monster. Yeah.
Benavides wants to fight him.
That's a good
They train in the same gym, and they told me, Brad, we'll fight each other.
Benavides, I think, beats him. I think Benavides got a better skill set.
He's strong.
Benavides got fast hands, man. Like, when he gets you in trouble.
First thing, I'll tell you, put it over there and respond to mom.
Who's he inspired? Jose?
Benavides.
Oh, David.